Hi everyone, welcome back to Linda Libra Loca. Today I wanted to talk about the skin barrier and what it has probably to do with acne, atopic dermatitis, or just general uncomfortable skin. We're going to cover the following topics. What is the skin's barrier? How do we damage the skin's barrier? What does a damaged skin barrier feel like? What does it matter if we damage our skin barrier? And what can we do to repair it? But firstly, welcome if you're new here. Hi, my name's Anne. I'm a doctor and a beauty lover, and I'm passionate about sharing beauty tips and tricks for people with more mature skin. You might not know that about me, but I suffer from a mild form of atopic dermatitis. And I recently, due to many factors, had a huge flare-up that was not contained to my body, but spread up over my chest and onto my face, which was not pretty, but reminded me that I've been meaning to talk about the damaged skin barrier for quite some time. What is the skin barrier? The skin barrier goes by many different names: lipid barrier, moisture barrier, or the most technical term, stratum corneum. It's basically the upper layer of dead skin cells. It's usually 10 to 20 layers of them. And in between, a lipid matrix made up of ceramides, around 60%, cholesterol, and fatty acids. On top of that, the skin has a mildly acidic pH, which helps activate some enzymes that are in this lipid matrix and help fight bacteria. So basically, the skin barrier keeps the good stuff, aka moisture, in, and keeps the bad stuff, aka bacteria and irritants, out. What does damage the skin barrier? Well, basically everything. There are environmental factors like wind, cold air, dry air. There are lifestyle factors like alcohol, smoking, pollution, medication we need to take, and stress, because stress increases cortisol levels, and cortisol leads to chronic inflammation and overproduction of sebum in our skin. Then, as always, we have age, because the amount of ceramides we have in our skin, which make up to 60% of the lipids in the skin barrier, decreases. And there are some innate conditions like acne, rosacea, and atopic dermatitis that come with a naturally weaker skin barrier. The biggest factor, though, are our habits. And the first one is overwashing our face. Water changes the pH of our skin, and any cleansers we put on our face, especially harsh cleanser, foaming cleanser, and alkaline cleansers, do not only disrupt the pH, but take away the oils that we need to protect or to form this protective barrier. I did a whole video on the topic of double cleansing and if it's actually bad for your skin, that I'm going to link in the cards here. But as a takeaway message, do clean your skin as often as necessary, but as gentle as possible. Another thing is over exfoliation. As I mentioned, the skin barrier is made up of 10 to 20 layers of dead skin, and these are needed. So if we are continuously exfoliating the upper layer, we are stripping our skin from this protective barrier. We do need to exfoliate as we age, because cell turnover gets slower, the cells don't shed as easily, and we end up with not 20 but 30, 35 layers on our skin, which makes it look tired or dull. But if we end up with just 5, this isn't good either, because it's just a weaker protection. And for that, it's really important to take a look at your routine and see what you are actually using that is exfoliating. Your cleansing brushes, they are physical exfoliants. Your microfiber or washcloths, physical exfoliants. The towel you rub your face with is a physical exfoliant. If you pair that with a daily gentle chemical peel like the Pixi Glow Tonic, and then maybe a weekly peel, you're just over exfoliating your skin, and that will get you in trouble. Then of course all the other actives we use, especially acne medication or things like retinol, but even vitamin C, which can be potentially irritating. So if you use them too often and combine too many, over time you can weaken your skin barrier. Another common mistake is not replenishing the lost lipids. I have been guilty of that as well. When I grew up, I would use the harshest cleanser I could on my face and then leave it without any kind of hydrating or moisturizing layer on top, just because I wanted to get rid of all the oil. But that made things worse, made my skin more prone to bacteria invading, and led to more acne breakouts. So a lightweight moisturizer that's aimed at acne prone and oily skin is actually a must. And the same goes for your body. If you take a long bath or a long shower and don't moisturize immediately afterwards, you will probably end up with dry patches everywhere. What does a damaged skin barrier feel like? While we all have a skin type, we also have skin conditions. And if these conditions change, this might be a warning sign. My skin type is combination oily. It gets more to normal now that I age. And my skin conditions are dehydration, mature, and acne prone. Some warning signs are if your skin gets really, really oily, but at the same time feels kind of tight and dehydrated. If you get breakouts in areas where you never had a breakout before, and these are really stubborn and hard to treat. If you develop product-resistant dry patches or flakes of eczema. If your skin feels inflamed and you develop redness. Or if skincare products that you've been using for a long time suddenly cause stinging and irritation. Why is a damaged skin barrier problematic? The skin acts as a barrier. So not only does a damaged skin barrier make it easier for water to evaporate, leading to dehydrated skin or an increase in transepidermal water loss, but it's also easier for bacteria and potential irritants to penetrate inside your skin. So A, you're more prone to breakouts and inflammation, and B, you're more prone to developing sensitivities. And this is why I personally, when you have a damaged skin barrier, do not recommend using essential oils or any other kind of fragrance. Not because they do damage the skin barrier, but because they can penetrate inside and the possibility of you developing an allergy against them is much higher than it is when your skin is functioning completely normal. And even without the dehydration and the bacteria invading leading to breakouts, your skin is actually pretty uncomfortable. And I don't want to run around with tight, itchy, red skin. I want my skin to feel plump and shiny and lovely. Skin barrier repair. How do you actually do it? As always, prevention is key. And you can't repair your skin barrier if you're leading a shitty lifestyle. Stop smoking, stop drinking, make sure you eat a balanced diet that contains all the good nutrients, manage your stress levels, work out, this is my preferred way, meditate, this might be what works for you, make sure you get enough sleep, and if all that is done, take a look at your skincare. Make sure you're using a gentle cleanser and then really access all your exfoliation and your actives. Do you need all of them? I mean, it's perfectly fine if you can apply a retinol, a vitamin C, and glycolic acid all in one setting. But the problem point is, you don't need to. So why would you? Spread them out to different days. Make sure you only use the actives that you and your skin really need. And of course, I'm guilty of shoving everything on my face. And trust me, I have paid the price many, many times. So look what you and your skin really need. And then make sure you use it as often as needed, but not too often. Look at your exfoliation. Once a week is probably fine. Don't use face brushes. Don't rub your face with your towel or your washcloth. Just gentle. Treat your skin gentle. If your skin is already damaged, then you need to make a plan. The first thing is to cut out everything and focus on gentle cleansing, a lot of hydration, and ingredients that help repair the skin barrier. The last time I damaged my skin barrier, it took me a little longer than a week before I slowly started reintroducing actives into my routine. This might be shorter for you if you catch it early. This might take even longer depending on your skin and how far it has been damaged. But your face is not going to fall off if you stop using your actives for a week. Gentle cleanser, hydration, and then a cream that's called a barrier repairing cream, a moisture cream, things like that. Basically a cream that contains phospholipids, ceramides, essential fatty acids to help replenish that. If you have something with niacinamide or if you have something with provitamin B5, then this might help on top to soothe and repair your skin. I will have a few product recommendations down in the description box. Urea and even lactic acid have been shown in some studies to help with rebuilding the skin barrier because they are slightly acidic and hydrating. So if your skin's pH is the problem, it's too alkaline due to your cleanses, this might work, but I personally did stay clear from even lactic acid for the time that my skin was upset with me. And once you feel like your skin is back in great condition, your breakouts go back, your skin looks even, there's no itching, no tightness, no eczema patches back, then you can slowly, slowly reintroduce your actives. Not more than one a week. Don't start using them every night. Really listen to your skin and see how much it can actually take. Skincare is a marathon, not a sprint. You need your skin to look good for the rest of your life. So if it takes you a week or two longer to introduce a retinol into your routine, this will not make you old overnight. That was hard because I'm kind of impatient, but I admit my skin looks the best that it has in quite a long time. So maybe this eczema flare-up was just a nudge in the right direction that I needed. I'm going to link a few videos on the screen that I think might interest you. I'd love to hear if you have experienced a damaged skin barrier and what you did do to heal it. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'm going to see you all very soon with another video. Bye!